Okay, hi everybody. This is Carly in the Pink Scrapper, and today we're going to show you how to make this cute little purse embellishment with one of the Stampin' Up! Round Tab punches. This actually fits into the legal size envelope, and it's 4 inches by 9 inches, so it's cute card, and I'm just going to show you how to do the little purse today. So I already have my punch, my paper punched out, and I'm going to show you what I do with my scrap paper, because everybody has it, and I still like to use, you know, whatever I can. So I went ahead and I punched a bunch of these, and so now when I need something, or maybe I just feel like making little embellishments, I can have all these ready, or to select, or have it to select from. So I just put it in an empty container, and then I just keep this for when I need it. So I actually just pulled this from this box here. Oops. Also, what you can do with this is you can emboss it, and I don't know if you can see that, but I put it in my Big Shot, and there's an embossing on there, so that just gives it a little bit of texture. And actually, the other thing, this is not just good for purses, it is a round tab. So what you do is fold it in half, and you know, when you make cards or albums, you can adhere it on there and it becomes a tab, which is what it's made for. But of course, as scrappers, we use it for everything else. You can also make flowers out of this, so just keep that in mind. So we're going to get started. You're also going to need a large size oval punch, and this is from Stampin' Up! As well. So I went ahead and punched that out. So all we're going to do is fold the tab, and we're going to cut this down to about 3/4 of the way. You can leave it longer. I don't, because all it's going to do is just flap over the back here. So I just try to make it as you know, less bulky as possible. Okay, so then first thing we can do is you can put a flower here, or a brad like I've done. You can even put a button on there, but I'm gonna put a brad today, and so I'm gonna make a puncture in both pieces of paper and then push my brad through. Maybe this is probably the hardest part of this project, for me anyways. Sorry about that. I'm also going to tell you a couple tips too that I use, and just share a couple things with you, so I hope you like those. Okay, so I'm going to put some adhesive on here. It's going to hold it down. You're going to fold that over, and then I just have a small piece of ribbon, and this is going to go, put adhesive there. I put the ends inside and then flap that around to make a little handle, and you can make it as long or as short as you want. I'm going to put more adhesive and then just seal that up, and then we're done. So there's your cute little purse. You can put glitter or stickles on it. There is a cute little dress that goes with this that I'll make for you too in the future, and you can put them together. Great for your girlfriends, great for little girls. So have fun with that. It's a great embellishment to make and super fun to make. What I'm also going to show you is I've discovered something called card candy. And so I joined a swap, and this is for Christmas, so I'm way ahead of schedule here. But what you can do is you use your scraps, is what I use, is my little pieces of scraps, and you make embellishments ahead of time so that you can make a quick card if you need to. So when Christmas comes and, you know, I'm super busy, I can take this and put it on a regular size A2 size card, and then I can, this has adhesive on it already, and this is on wax paper. So I'm going to take this maybe and put this on the inside. Then I have a card completed, and then I also have this one on the back. So anyways, this is called card candy, and it's something new that I just discovered. I'm sure it's been out on the market for a while. I'm just kind of not in the loop on that. But if you hear me talk about card candy, I love making embellishments, and now I know that there's a name for it. So anyways, this is an awesome tip to how to use your scraps. The other thing I want to tell you is how I've been storing my my extra paper. And, you know, we all get a lot of scraps, so, and we want to utilize everything. So I bought this album, and I just started colorizing all the colors together. So if I have something, you know, like my little purse here, and I don't have it in my tin, I'll come through here and look for it, and then get the pieces I need, and then I'm not wasting any paper. So anyways, so far this, I just started this a month ago, and I really, really like it because it keeps me organized. This album is actually an 8x8 album, and so I kind of make sure that anything larger than that I store with my regular cardstock. Anything smaller goes into the album there. Okay, the other thing, one more tip I'm going to give you, or not a tip actually, just kind of a shout out to my friend Sylvia in Arizona. I'm going to be sending her this cute little pop-up card that I made, and maybe in the future, if there's enough requests for it, I'll show you guys how to make it. But it's a very simple pop-up, and you can change it however you want to, and it just kind of makes it fun. So Sylvia, this card's for you. The other thing I want to tell you is that since I am a Stampin' Up! demonstrator, I want to offer all my viewers a special. So what I'm going to do is, for any orders starting on June 1st, you can order online, of course. You can go to my blog, and there's a link on there that says Shop With Me. So if you go to pinkscrapper99blogspot.com and you order $50 or more from my Stampin' Up! Website, you'll get a free catalog. But also, I will send you the tutorial that I'm working on for this. And that's going to be absolutely free for you. The cards, your little cards will fit in here. And you can put some embellishments. And on the back here, you can put maybe your pencils or even some more cards or something. But it's a super cute desk organizer. And I made up the pattern. So I want to offer this to you, and you can use any cardstock that you want, but you'll have the instructions on hand. So that's going to be my thank you and my gift to you folks. So thanks for watching. If you guys have questions, as always, just email me at pinkscrapper99yahoo.com, or leave a message on the video responses, and I'll get back to you. So thanks a lot. You guys have a great day. Bye.